Okay, hi guys. Today I'm at Cerezo 7 in Milan and I'm gonna do a shoulder workout. And I thought I'd do my first ever live video, so here we go. We'll start with some shoulder press, classic shoulder builder. Front press is the best builder for the shoulder, but it also involves the upper pec. So it's important to really tense your abs when you're doing so that you don't arch your back too much. I think that might add some more weight. Took like 3 weeks off the gym, so this was my first week back. I have to say, I'm really sore. It's just, it's always like that. It's like, you come back nice and rested, nice and strong, so you lift really heavy, but your muscles are not quite used to that anymore. So, crazy dumps after. My legs, I walk like I'm 90 years old. But we're almost there. It's, I think I've done everything this week. I feel good. For those of you who are curious, those are 70 kilos I'm lifting. I'm trying to do as many reps as I can, keeping my legs locked. So all the load goes on the shoulders and you're not using your legs. And if you notice my last rep, I was tired, so I gave a little push with my knees. It's like a cheat rep to do the next one. I shouldn't do all of them like that, because otherwise, you're not isolating me very well. Also, go check out the Petro Design page, my outfit. As you know, I make all these clothes. I design them and made here in Italy. I think I can go ahead. I love this gym so much because it's like, it has these like small rooms. If you look around, it's like, I wish my living room was like this actually. exactly. The weights, rowing machines. This is kill wheel. This is like, it's like pushing a sledge. It's the best type of cardio to do because I'm not pushing hard. And then of course, the golden balls. Make you put the rest in hand, even in the middle of winter. This is everything you need. Reps to really shock the system, and then you can go back down a notch. It's been on Fashion Week, by the way. This is how I spend my time here. I should probably should be at shows. A little bit. Last night I had the GQ awards. I got an award for one of the best dressed men in Italy, which I was honored, to be honest. It was a bit unexpected. But you know, it's fine. I actually like wearing suits when I can find one that fits. Usually they need to be tailor-made. So this next exercise, I'm gonna go behind the neck. So far I've been resting at the front. That's when you're at the strongest, pressing up. When you go behind the neck, you eliminate the involvement of the upper pecs, so you isolate the delts more. So you can lift, you can't lift as much weight, but you also isolate them better. It takes a while to get used to the movement, so if you start light, because you can, you know, in the long term, if you're not doing it correctly, you can injure your shoulder. The last one doesn't happen. I trained my arms yesterday, so I really feel like my triceps are really tired when I'm pushing up. We're going to do arms on my last day of the week. But mixing it up helps as well. Thank you. for the last set, and then for the round. The faces you do are important. They show the effort, you know? Okay, so the next exercise is upright rows. It's very good to build the shoulders, the delts, but also the upper traps. Especially the final part where you squeeze. This is also an exercise that takes time to get used to because of the awkward position of the wrist. Like in everything, you need practice. Start from a low weight, be patient. It's easy to be tempted to do heavy weight right away. You build the technique and then put on the weight. And then you'll get to the point where you do like short, intense workouts. I'm doing today. Chatting too much. We really don't chat as much when we work out. start pinching the back. Inside of me now, which made it weak to pay for leg day, but my legs are not taking it today, so this is why we got a shoulder workout. That probably doesn't make any sense for me. Now down. The rest of the isolation work, which is better to do after the compound moves because of an effect called potentiation. So we increase the frequency response of the muscles now, so even if you do isolation work, it will work even better. So why don't we do some 17 and a half kilos in each hand. I like to do it reasonably heavy. Try to always keep my arms as straight as possible, so I'm not bending too much. Otherwise, the moment about the shoulder joint is reduced. Remember, the moment is what the muscle is actually performing. It's a moment. It's an angular force. And it's equal to the weight times the distance. So if you decrease the distance, you're decreasing the strength of the muscle, essentially. This is a good first live video. I'm happy this is what we're doing. My favorite gym. I could hear you, but I can't. Okay, I'm gonna try and show you now from the back what's happening. Good burn. pasta and last night. Nothing vascular.
In this freak vein you have as well.
Okay, what I said then. The rest of my work on private. I've been chilling it out. Okay.
Shoulder workout. Probably another couple of things you could do is front raises to isolate the front of the belts. But really, once you've done these five exercises, the rest is just you can go sit in front of the mirror, do the mirror exercises, how I call them, easy ones. Stay focused for the first 20, 25 minutes, and you're done. So, good night guys. It's nice having you here. Bye now.